What's up, guys? My name is Jordy for CineCam.net, and you're watching Copycat Friday. Now, in this series, we recreate certain effects from famous films and music videos, and today we're having a look at J-Rock and Kendrick Lamar.
And in the music clip, Wow Freestyle, you can see a pretty cool effect, where one person dances in slow motion, and the other one dances in normal speed. And this is what we are recreating today.
A couple of weeks ago, J-Rock came out with a new music video called Wow Freestyle, featuring Kendrick Lamar. And there's this pretty cool effect in there in which we can see one of them play back at normal speed while the other is set at slow motion, and then they switch. It's actually pretty easy to do, so I'd like to focus on some extra things in this video as well, and that is camera movement. Very often we get the question, Jordy, why do I need to film from a tripod when creating such effects? How can I add movement to my shots and still make it work? Well, that's one of the things that we're gonna take a look at in this video. But first, let's have a look at Storyblocks, our channel sponsor. Storyblocks is a huge online library packed with studio quality stock clips, video effects, transitions, templates, and so much more. We've been using it ourselves for a very long time and really love how we can just download anything we like instantly without having to pay extra. And that way we can try out different stock clips or effects until we find the right piece that goes into our edit. To check it out yourself, make sure to follow the first link in the description below. And now let's jump into the studio. Hey, Janik, catch! There we go, everything has been set up. Now for the convenience, we're doing this in our studio. Obviously, it's not the same as on the playground with the basketball field and everything in a real music video, but we kind of have the same feeling to it. And what we've done is created a fence with cue poles and light stands. We've got some blue lighting in the back, which can also be seen in the music video. And finally, we've got these trees, and that has been created with using a theater spot and putting a template in there from some trees, and then just shining that onto the back wall. Let's start with the basics first to understand how the effect goes. You're gonna give each person a specific amount of time to say their lines. For example, 4 seconds. And that means you're gonna get 2 seconds when dancing in slow motion. Because if we're gonna make the speed go half as fast in post-production, we're gonna end up with 4 seconds again. So you say a few lines within your first 4 seconds, and then you go and dance for 2 seconds. You can then say a few lines again for 4 seconds, dance for 2 seconds, and so on. Your friend will then stand on the other side of the shot. He or she will now start with dancing for 2 seconds, then say a few lines for 4 seconds, etc. And it's gonna be really important that you're gonna synchronize this. So it might be good to have another person holding a stopwatch and giving instructions. We can then jump into Premiere Pro and put one shot on the bottom of your timeline and the other one on top. With the top clip selected, head over to the effects controls and under opacity, take the pen tool to draw a mask around your subject that goes through the middle of your shot. And this will reveal the clip below and put your two characters next to each other in the same frame. And now you want to synchronize the two clips. Now what helps is by looking at the audio waveforms. We can clearly see here where one person talks and the other one dances. The dance parts are of course too fast, so we're gonna have to add a cut around that. Move the right clip away, right click on the dance part, choose speed and duration, and then set the speed to 50%, which is gonna put that 2 second part to 4 seconds, synchronizing it with the clip below. Then keep doing that for all the parts, which is gonna give you a similar result as in a music video. And by the way, guys, there's also a way to create a smoother time remapping, but we have a dedicated video about that, which can be found in the description below. Hey guys, I can talk a little bit for 4 seconds, but now I have to start dancing.
Hello, I'm Janik and I love to dance, but also love to talk.
Oh man, my dance moves are just so lit. Look.
Dancing is fun, but it's really hard in slow motion.
And now comes the question, but in a music video, the camera moves. And that is not fake camera movement, because we can see clearly a change in perspective. The way that they've probably done it is by using a motion-controlled crane such as the Bolt, which we've made a couple of videos about in the past. And one of which is how to fake the fast movement of the crane seen in Humble from Kendrick Lamar. Now with this effect, we can't really fake it, as it's gonna require some programming to be done in the camera crane itself. Essentially, it's gonna have to make the exact same movement twice in order to put the two clips on top of each other with the mask, but also synchronize the slow motion and the normal speed at the same time. I mean, we can do that 4 versus 2 seconds trick again, which will synchronize the talking and the slow motion dancing, but it won't synchronize the camera movement. So we're gonna have to make the camera movement from the robot arm switch between two different speeds. Unfortunately, we don't have such a motion-controlled camera crane. But I was able to borrow something from a friend that kind of works in the same principle. This right here is a camera slider. Nothing really special, but it comes with this accessory right here, which allows me to motion control that camera. Now, it's not really the same as the bolt, which can go in all kinds of directions, but it has the same principle. I can set a specific speed with this slider, take my first shot, then take another shot at the exact same speed, and those two shots will match perfectly if I will lay them on top of each other. Now what about the effect that we are trying to create, where we need two different speeds? Well, I can do that inside this control as well. I can actually set how long the duration has to go from one end to another. For example, I can set it to 20 seconds, like that. Then I will just let the camera roll and do my talking part. When it's done, I kind of freeze in my movement and let someone else change the duration to 10 seconds, which is half of 20, of course. And then we'll start dancing. And we're then going to put the dancing part into slow motion, that 10 seconds becomes 20 seconds, and thus everything will be synchronized. So here's the shot of me talking in normal speed. Then I stand still as possible while Janik changes the speed of the slider, and then I go back into my dancing. You can already go ahead and cut the part out where I stand still. Then cut out my dancing part, and like before, change the speed to 50%. Also here, we're gonna draw a mask through the middle, which will reveal the clip below. And this is the same as we've previously seen. But now comes the tricky part. The camera moves, so we're gonna have to nudge the clip to synchronize the camera movement of the two clips. And this has to be done for both the speaking parts and the slow motion dancing parts. And once you got it synchronized, the effect should already work. Now, of course, there's this jump cut, but there's an easy way to make that less noticeable. We're going to add some fake camera movement to it, which I was talking about previously. And this is a second way of adding movement to your effects, which we can also do on a tripod shot or mix it in with real camera movement. We're gonna make an adjustment layer from the projects panel and place that on top of the entire edit. From your effects library, search for the transform effect and just drag that to the adjustment layer. From here, I can start the animation for the position and the scale. Move forward in time and change those values to zoom into the shot and pan or tilt around. You can make multiple of these movements to make it appear organic. At the point where you have your cut, you want to make a fast camera movement. For example, I'm zoomed in to myself right here. Then I just go a few frames forward and zoom completely out. The closer your keyframes are together, the faster your animation goes. As a final touch, I'm gonna disable to use the composition shutter angle and set 180 degree to introduce motion blur into those camera movements. Now when it comes down to your animations or keyframes, make sure that they go smooth. By right-clicking on them, you can choose Ease In or Ease Out. Choosing Ease In will make the animation stop smooth, and Ease Out will make the animation start smooth. You can also set the keyframe to Bezier to make it both stop and start smooth. And today we're having a look at J-Rock and Kendrick Lamar.
And in the music clip, Wow Freestyle.
And that was it again for Copycat Friday. If you like to see more breakdowns, then make sure to hit that subscribe button down below to see us twice a week. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for your support. And like always, stay creative.
Turning the screws. Making a fence.
Janik, ik heb 4 kranten te krijgen. Janik, het is 4 kranten! Janik!